What's going on, guys? Jeff from Nrdly here. We're standing in the back room here at Starbase 1552 Comics, just opened up in Franklin, Tennessee. And I'm here with Nalini. You were in Star Wars Episode 2, Attack of the Clones.
That is correct. I played a character called Barriss Offee.
How was that experience?
I'm still here today to tell the experience of that whole film and the legacy it's created. And I'm in Nashville, Tennessee because of that film, and I travel a lot because of that film, so it has been a life-changing experience for me.
What was it like working with the grandmaster of geekdom, George Lucas?
He, believe it or not, is the nicest, the most down-to-earth individual you will ever meet. So cool. I have more respect for him because of that. And, you know, just he has such a creative imagination to be part of that saga that he's created, which will never end, has been going on for generation after generation. I don't even know what to say. I mean, he's an amazing, amazing guy. And I'm looking forward to what, you know, Star Wars will bring moving forward. But yeah, he's just an amazing guy, and it'll be interesting to see what it's going to be like with him not in the picture now.
So were you a Star Wars fan growing up?
I did watch the Star Wars films. I must admit, I did love Star Trek a lot. Oh, I know I shouldn't mention that.
Hey, no, it's totally cool. Totally cool.
but I did watch the repeats. But I was more in love with, and being, you know, I was watching the repeats as a child because these movies came out when I wasn't alive. So, you know, when I was watching the repeats, I was fascinated with Ewok adventures because, you know, for kids, it's exciting.
Yes. Somebody else with the Ewok love.
Yeah, I
get made fun of for loving that so much.
I love the Ewok adventures. I mean, I'd go back and watch them again and again. You know, I loved it. I love the Ewok adventures.
She's officially my favorite person on the planet. Okay, so what was the experience like being on set? You know, you played a Jedi padawan, is that correct? Okay, so what was the experience like, you know, holding a lightsaber, working with the other Jedi actors and actresses?
Well, it wasn't anything like I had imagined. I mean, I've been on set quite a bit doing films. And, you know, being an actor, you are professional. It is very different. You're not dealing with the end product. You're, you know, dealing with the bare basics. So, you know, when I went in, initially, I didn't even know what I was doing. And I just knew that they'd called me in. And the next thing I know, they were fitting me out to build my costume. Then I went on set. And, you know, it was like a typical set. You've got your lights, you've got your blue screen, your green screen. But then when they kept calling me in and I was doing these fight scenes, you know, then I sort of started to get an understanding that I had this bigger part to play in the film. And so it kept very quiet. But the whole experience was just unlike anything I'd ever done. I got to wield a lightsaber, with the stunt coordinator, Nick Gillard. And he was the main coordinator for all of his fight scenes. So, you know, I got to work with him, which was just so amazing. And then I got to do these, you know, tandem fighting scenes. Then I got to do, you know, just the standard scenes you do, you know, in the Jedi Council. So I sort of got an idea of, you know, what was going on in the film as we were filming. And it was all unfolding, you know, in front of me. And I just, I can't really sort of there's no one word to describe my experience, but it was really surreal. That's the only way I can describe. But I had the best fun, and I'd do it all over again if I could.
Have you kept up with kind of your character through like the Clone Wars series and all that? Or?
Yeah, I actually watched the scene recently where it was disclosed that she, you know, she betrayed Ahsoka, and that amazing fight scene that followed. And I know that she's gone to the dark side, and I have been watching that. And I must tell you, I am very disappointed to hear that she has gone to the dark side because it's so unlike her character. But yes, I have been keeping an eye. I mean, you have to keep an eye on your character and what they're doing with it. And I hear that she could be coming back as an Inquisitor. I don't know that for sure, but yeah.
Yeah, that was the rumor I heard. Thank you so much for taking time to talk to us. I really appreciate it. One last question. Is there anything you could say to any aspiring actresses or models or actors out there to kind of give them encouragement?
Definitely. And welcome, by the way. It was such a pleasure to meet you both. I would say that if you want to be an actor, you need to be a go-getter. You cannot just sit back and wait for work to come to you. It's a very competitive industry. And the second thing I'd like to say is always believe in yourself, because you are who you are. You're unique. There's no one else out there like you. And if you're unique and you're yourself, then you know, it's only a matter of time before someone sees that uniqueness. And go out and create your own productions. Me and my friend are setting up a production company, and we've got some great ideas about productions. And if you're an actor, it's not about being in the biggest blockbuster film. It's not about being, you know, famous. It is about, you know, the art of acting and the art of producing and putting these projects together that can really send a message. So if you truly want to do that, you could do it any day of the week. You know, you just need a camera and you just need the motivation. So do something every day for your career. If you truly want to be an actor, every day, whether it's reading, you know, a book on acting, doing a class, you know, pitching to an agent, whether it's going, you know, and doing accent classes, but do something every day if it's truly your passion. And, you know, you reap what you sow. So at the end of the day, if you put the effort in, there is no reason why you shouldn't be successful at what you do. And everyone thinks that success is up here and it's an A-list and it's celebrity, but success is what you make it. And if you're, you know, constantly making short films, you're successful because you are able to complete a short film. So always, I think, having that mindset that success is not, you know, a certain ideal and it is what you make it.
Well, I would say we're successful because we're doing what we love here. Awesome. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. It's nice to meet you.